today we're down here at Lehigh Gorge State Park in Pennsylvania. It's a beautiful park. It's got some nice mountains and it's got something called Glen Onoko Falls. Forgive me if I pronounced that wrong. We're going to take a look at a little bit about the history of it and such as we go along here. But that's going to be our destination here at Lehigh Gorge State Park. We're going to hike these treacherous trails, as some would call them, up to the top and give you a view of the beautiful borough of Jim Thorpe that lies beneath. And for this trip, I have my official VAPI canteen, and this was just made official today. This was made the official canteen of Virginia Paranormal Investigations. We'll get you the brand name later on. So let's hit the trail. Now our first stop here, it's gonna be this old train tunnel. No longer has tracks going through it. There are some railroad ties in there. And now we can actually walk through it and get a scenic view of the river down below. So here we go inside. You can see it's pretty dark inside, but there's the light at the end of the tunnel, if you will. And that's where we're heading, towards the light. Let's go check it out. And you can see down here on the ground, the old railroad ties that still go across from when there used to be tracks in here. It's a pretty nice scenic view. There's the old pillars from where the tracks used to cross the water. And some summer enthusiasts down below enjoying kayaking and swimming in the river. What do you think?
I think it's great. It's awesome. I mean, it's neat that you can still see the stanchions. I don't know what you call those things that used to support the railroad when it went across here. And I mean, that's just awesome. This whole cave and the rock formations and everything is just beautiful. It's a shame that people have spray painted on the rocks and, you know, had to make it ugly.
Yeah, and some of the spray paint looks, some of it looks very old.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably been years and years ago since they spray painted.
Yeah, some guy named Jay Bird came through here. And
so Jay Bird was tagging
the walls. Yeah, Jay
Bird. What'd you do that for, Jay Bird? But nonetheless, beautiful scenery from up here. And it's like we're standing in the side of a rock ledge.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll show you, when we go across here, you'll be able to see this this tunnel from the other side of the water. And it's pretty cool to see where we were, where we are now. But
very nice.
So we're gonna trek on back through the train tunnel here and over to the other side of the river. And you can really see on this end how they blocked off the entrance of the tunnel. I mean, the railroad ties are down here. And we gotta hike up this pretty steep hill to get out of here. So at one time it was probably blocked off pretty good, huh? So here's the bridge to cross over the stream, and we'll give you a view of that train tunnel from the other side. So there's where we're standing at the end of that train tunnel. Like I said, it's just like a hole in the side of the mountain. Really, really cool. There's something interesting in the water down here. It looks like somewhat of a foundation. If you can see that rectangular shaped object just below the water. And some beautiful scenery up here at Lehigh Gorge State Park. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so what this board tells us here is that basically this was a beautiful place. It had a beautiful resort hotel. Once again, forgive the pronunciation, I believe it's Hotel Wahneta. And that's what it looked like right there. A very big place, 47 room hotel. Beautiful area to sit and relax and take in the view. And a legend formed here about Onoko Falls, which is the one in that top picture there. And Glen Onoko Falls is supposed to mark the spot where a, to quote the sign, heartbroken young Native American woman leaped to her death when told she could not marry her love. So that is our destination for today. It's got a legend associated with it, quite a history, and it looks like it was a beautiful area. And even though there's no traces of the resort that once was here, nature's come back to reclaim it, as with many of the locations we go to that once were, and it's still a beautiful area. It's got a natural beauty to it, beautiful waterfalls, and a beautiful scene that we're going to go up and take in and show you. What I did notice on this sign is it did say that there used to be a platform up there. It looks like there used to be a platform where you could go out, and they said it went out over the abyss and provided a picturesque view. So we're going to go to that area where you can get that picturesque view. There's no platform there, as I recall, at least not still in existence. And I'm not sure if it's the exact area where the platform was, but we're going to go up there nonetheless and show you the view.
So the park has, it says, many historic ruins, including locks, dams, and towpaths. I'm not sure what a towpath is, but maybe we'll figure it out.
Is it a path for a tow?
It could be. It could be. For your own safety and preservation of historic treasures, please keep off the ruins. But we can certainly get some good pictures of them.
Absolutely. And just before we get started, we'll give you a little overview of the map of Lehigh Gorge State Park. So we're going to head down these stairs right here that go down to the start of the trail. So just that you can see, I wasn't exaggerating. There's actually a warning behind me here. And it says, warning, Glen Onoko Falls, hike at your own risk. Sections of the trail are steep and treacherous. So treacherous was a good adjective.
Right.
To describe these trails.
But you gotta read the rest.
They even used it in the sign.
Hikers have been seriously injured and killed as a result of accidental falls from the trail and gorge overlooks.
That's like the small print.
Yes.
Right there. So I kind of left that out, but nonetheless.
Yes, but that's the dramatic part you have.
That's to. Right. That and that, ladies and gentlemen, that is the trail that we're about to undertake right there. So
yeah.
Let's go see what they got. Wear proper hiking shoes. You have the Colemans, I have the Diehards. I think we'll be good. I mean, these shoes worked pretty good for us yesterday.
Right, yeah.
Trekking across Boulder Field out into the depths of the boulders. Let's go. And that's the bridge we crossed over to get here. Looks like it was another old train bridge, perhaps. And we did notice an old plaque up there on the side of the railroad bridge. We can't really make out what it says.
Oh, it says the Pennsylvania Steel Company.
Oh, okay.
Steelton, Pennsylvania, and it says 19th for some reason. I'm not sure what the 19th indicates, because there's no other indication of age or date.
Could that be the year, maybe?
It just says 19th. I don't know.
Maybe the 19th year. That's the only thing I could think of.
Could be.
No, there's something underneath it that says 19... Or is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. 19th. At least I think that's what it says. Unless it's
1910, perhaps?
10? I can't make out that last letter or number.
Perhaps some old foundations here at the start of the trail. Old posts and some concrete. Coming down the side of the hill by the second bridge. How do they get there to spray paint? Do they bring ladders? Or do they, like, kind of lower themselves down? That's what I've always wondered about that.
This one is actually pretty easy. See, you can jump up on this thing, on the concrete ledge, and then you can step up onto the metal ledge that's up there.
Oh, okay.
So that's not that hard, but...
I mean, see that.
There were some other places, like the front ledge, lower ledge of the opening of the tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
How the hell do they get there? The only way is to hang.
That's a good question.
Yeah.
But something interesting. I think that plaque's in 1913.
Think so?
Yes. Look behind you right there. It does say 1913.
Wow. Yeah.
And this old brick wall here. So perhaps that's what it said on the plaque. I don't know. And there, once again, if you can see it in this pillar, the year 1913.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I'm guessing a very old structure up above us here, very old railroad trestle.
High atop the hill there, you'll see the sign that says welcome to Glen Onoko Trail. So a small little incline we're gonna have to go up to get to it.
Some more old foundations along the way. I imagine part of the railroad maybe. I'm not sure what that was. I'm not sure where in reference to this the hotel sat.
No, there were old telephone. See the old telephone pole?
Oh yeah, yeah. It's typical
for following a railroad line. Perhaps some old telegraph posts.
And look at this. See, this is interesting because this is one of those fallen tree formations that they describe that the Sasquatch make out in the woods.
Really?
To mark their territory. Yep.
Huh. So Sasquatch might have made that kind of like a flag.
Could be. Could
That's
be.
That's interesting.
That's interesting. I also noticed, if I can find it again, right here. See, there's several old bricks in the ground from a structure that once was. You can tell they're very old. Been here quite some time, so.
Got a glimpse of a train coming down the tracks here. I've never seen that before. You know, we just happened to be hiking by right at the right time, just enough to catch this train as the engine was coming by, and we caught some video of it, which is pretty cool. And it's very picturesque how it goes down here around the bend between the rocks. Very nice scenery up here. It's
yes.
Something that I would build on like a train platform or something like that. You know, it's
right.
perfect. But ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna venture back into the woods here and back on the trail.
All right, here we go, up the trail.
And another sign warning that the trail is rather dangerous.
So in case you miss the giant sign at the bottom of the trail,
mm-hmm.
right at the bottom of the stairs.
Right.
They have signs along the trail. So if you happen to venture up the side of a cliff and ignore the sign that says treacherous trails, there are several danger signs along the way. That being one of them, and perhaps another one up the top here.
There's an old pipe going across the trail there.
I wonder if that's something to do with the hotel or not. And once again,
another sign that says this trail is extremely dangerous.
This looks to be man-made. Somewhat of a man-made structure. I mean, the way the rocks are stacked. Yes, I would say definitely man-made.
There's a hole in the ground, also lined with rocks. Unless perhaps another structure built by a Yeti.
And once again, caution, dangerous trail.
So in case you've missed all the warnings up to this point, here's another.
So my question is, what about the people who come up here and to hike the trails and don't speak English? What do they do? Are those maybe the ones who have fallen off and been killed?
They could be.
Because they didn't read the warning signs?
They could be. That's a good question. So what if they put it in like Spanish too, maybe? But then what about people that don't speak Spanish or English?
Yeah, because I could see.
You know, they should probably have every single language listed on a sign.
Right, right.
Right?
At least on the big sign back there.
Yeah, or maybe note to self and take note of this for you as well. What we would advise is before you travel to any country that you're not familiar with the language, learn the word danger.
Yes.
In that language. Because if you know that word,
right.
You know where to stay away from.
Yep.
All right, pretty cool area of the trail we're coming up to now.
Kind of curves around the rock ledges here. And from the sounds of it, we may be coming up to our first waterfall of the journey. Or expedition, I think I'll call it. Expedition is always a cool word. Wow. Look down there in the ravine.
That's amazing.
Really nice, a little stream. Ice water. I'll tell you what, if I had a bathing suit, I'd be swimming in there.
Look at those rock ledges coming up here.
Pretty cool, right up to the trail.
We're gonna continue along the way here, and it's somewhat steep on the side, so if you ever trek out this way, mind your footing. Don't try to videotape while you're walking, because you could very well be looking at the video screen and, just kidding, I'm still here. All right, so here we go, back on the trail. If you do not have appropriate hiking boots, turn back now.
Now, I hate to make a reference that I always make, but this reminds me of like an episode of Scooby-Doo where they're going up to a haunted house, and it's like, haunted house ahead, turn back, beware, danger. Don't go any further. Yes. And they keep going.
Of course,
know what I mean?
Yes.
And that's kind of like this is, only with hiking boots and treacherous trails.
Right.
That could cause sudden death. But continuing on, here we go.
And over here we have some beautiful mountain laurel growing on the side of the trail. And you can see afar across the way there, it's growing all up the side of the mountain, all up the side of the rock cliff. Isn't that awesome? All those little white things are the mountain laurel. Here we are coming up on our first little waterfall as the water trickles down over the rocks here. And venturing further, caution, slippery rocks. And I trekked down here a little ways just to show you the scenery. How about down here in the river? Is this perhaps another Bigfoot marker? I don't know. And here we are above the waterfall here where Linda has sampled some of the water.
I have, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna like end up getting dysentery or one of those sort of intestinal diseases, but there's this nice little spot where the water flows off. As you can see.
And, look at that.
Yeah. And I wish you could fill this water. I mean, it's got to be all of about 40, 45 degrees. It's just, you know, frigid. And it feels great. Feels great. I'm tempted to fill up my canteen the rest of the way with it.
Now, I found this structure down here. If you look behind us, down there in the stream, you see those rocks stacked up down there.
Yes, I saw that.
Is that a Bigfoot marker?
It might be. And there's another one right there, closer.
Oh yeah, look at that. I didn't even see that one, closer. Yeah. So you have it, ladies and gentlemen, that is quite possibly Bigfoot's building blocks.
Or some form of witchcraft. So you never touch weird things like that that you find out in nature.
Okay, I tripped over one.
That might be a problem.
Okay.
Now what I love about this trail is that each time you come to a waterfall, you go up a little higher and there's another waterfall.
Right.
It's like a plethora of waterfalls. So let's continue on.
And a little farther up the stream, another trickling waterfall coming down. Now we found this stick here that looks a little rounded on the end. And I'm thinking perhaps a weapon used by Bigfoot. What do you think?
I think that's a good possibility. I mean, it certainly looks like it's been whittled off at the very end.
Right.
Sharpened to a point. Who knows?
Yeah, I'd pick it up and take a look at it, but perhaps a witch put it there. So maybe I should continue along crossing the stream. And ladies and gentlemen, if you come across this way, caution, slippery rocks.
Caution biking down this trail.
Yeah, I wouldn't advise taking a mountain bike down here.
No.
If you're considering that, ladies and gentlemen, you may want to find an alternate route if there is one.
Right.
because I just don't think the terrain is very appropriate for it. But nonetheless, ascending the rocks up to Glen Onoko Falls. Once again, a view of the stream and the waterfalls along the path.
All right, so I explored around a little bit, and there's a pretty awesome waterfall right up here over this little one. We're just trying to figure out the best way to get around to it. As you see behind me, fairly good climb. And over here, there's some slippery rocks, but potentially an easier way. I'm not sure. We might try to go up that way. So a slightly interesting event that just happened. We're climbing up. And just to tell you another thing to watch out for, we're climbing up this ledge here behind us, and over the little hill there, it goes almost, it's got a pretty good decline, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, it's not just straight up, it's like back and up, like, so, you know.
Right.
Yeah, you really got to have your footing.
And you heard.
Yeah, I just heard some, what sounded like a rocks, you know.
Like a rock slide.
Yeah.
It was like, it sounded like something, maybe something heavy running through the woods.
Right.
Like boom, 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 boom. And just to be on the safe side, man, I was halfway up that hill.
Yeah.
I scurried back down there, jumped to the side, and sure enough, a rock, probably about.
At least as big as a softball.
Yeah, at least as big as a softball.
Like a grapefruit size.
A grapefruit size rock, maybe two grapefruits, maybe a small bowling ball. Came rolling down the hill on the path I was on. So that just goes to say, ladies and gentlemen, keep your ears open when you're on these trails, because it's not just your footing you have to watch. You also have to have situational awareness. You have to be aware of what's going on around you in case there is a rock coming towards you or a large animal or something that you need to get out of the way. So let's go take a look at this waterfall up ahead here.
And right at the end of this treacherous trail here is a beautiful waterfall. And if you can see up above it, a little further, is another waterfall, which we'll get to. But very, very beautiful scenery here as the water goes down through the mountain laurel and under the old logs and trickles down the side of the mountain.
Now look at this, ladies and gentlemen. If you notice behind me here, there's another one of these little witch Bigfoot things. And it kind of makes you wonder, is there witchcraft being performed out here? Has Bigfoot been here? It seems like a perfect watering hole for a Bigfoot. These mountains are dense enough that Bigfoot would see you coming up the hill. And people are taking pictures of something on the hill over there. I'm hoping that it's not a reptile because I'm not fond of them. But nonetheless, what is that, ladies and gentlemen? Bigfoot's building blocks? Or a witch's spell beneath a waterfall. I don't know, let's go to Linda for some insight on that. So this little marker that's behind us here, the Bigfoot marker, if you will.
Yeah.
What are some of the theories as to why Bigfoot would build with rocks?
Well, of course, it's one of those things that, like you said, it's all theory.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people have different guesses as to what it might be. It might be something to mark that this is a sacred area. It could be a place to mark that, you know, this is just his territory, a territorial marker, if you will. You know, or it, who knows, it could be a place to mark that this is his rest spot. This is where he goes poopy.
Maybe to let other big feet or big foots,
right.
Maybe let other big feet know that he was here.
Yeah, it could be his restroom sign, you know.
Or maybe it's like Hansel and Gretel. It's like the breadcrumbs so that he can find his way back.
It could be.
Because
could
following the stream down the cliff would be probably a little too hard.
Could be, and it may be that, you know, this is because Sasquatch are thought to be, you know, to roam. They're supposed to roam around the country, so that may be one of those things where, you know, he's, like you said, marking his territory, like the breadcrumbs or the trail, you know. Who knows?
All right, now we're gonna scale this hill here. There's two ways to go, to the left or to the right. I'm thinking the right looks
a little less treacherous.
Yes.
However, nonetheless, if one of these rocks starts rolling, we're up the creek without a paddle.
Yeah.
And here we are going up the hill.
So as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, it's quite a trail up here, up this rock ledge from the waters down below. But nonetheless, we made it without any falling rock hazard or slippery rock hazard. That is a big, is it a millipede?
I believe so, yes.
And it's a pretty cool thing to get this close of a look at it. And it's a long one.
Who's a millipede?
Linda's gonna pet him, because that's normal. And there he goes. But watch your footing,
wow.
Watch your hand. So here is the view
from the top of that trail.
Look at this waterfall. This is something beautiful. You can see it through the trees. Forgive the jittering of the camera. And beware of the slippery rocks.
I gotta say, this is quite an impressive waterfall in front of us here. What are your thoughts?
I think I see another rock formation made by the Sasquatch.
Yes, times two.
On the far side. Oh yeah, there's a couple.
Or maybe
of them
there's
there.
Like four of them, the remnants of four of them.
Oh yeah, there's quite a few of them,
wow.
Right here.
What is going on with these rock formations?
I don't know, but it's really cool.
Yeah, perhaps.
I mean, it's hard to believe that somebody, a human at least, would take the time to come up here and just stack rocks. I mean,
yeah.
What would be the purpose behind that?
There'd be no purpose behind it.
No, but I could certainly see with, you know, Bigfoot's lack of design skill and inability to create a nice big cedar sign sandblasted like we can.
Right.
You know, maybe he would stack rocks.
It's quite possible. Well, let's go take a closer look at him, a closer look at the waterfall, and if we have time before we trek up the hill, let's stack some rocks.
This is quite impressive. For one, there's the top of the waterfall we were at before we trekked up the rocks there. And the water trickles around from this waterfall here. Here's the top of that last waterfall. And quite a view through the trees here. And to the rear. What a beautiful sight. Now look at this, ladies and gentlemen. This is very interesting. Rock stacking all around this waterfall. You can see some over there, some that have fallen. And they go all the way around. And then there's some on that big rock right up there. And ladies and gentlemen, as we venture a little closer, look at this large rock pile right in the middle there. It's almost in the shape of a pyramid. And a closer look at some of the other rock stacks. And behind us here, another one. And those are some big rocks that are stacked up there. Like, for a person to take those up and do that, they had to have some drive, that's for sure.
Just to give you an idea of how big these rocks are, I'm not going to go any closer. In case they are pertaining to witchcraft of some sort, but those are some big rocks. That took a little bit of arm strength and a good back to get those up on that rock, for sure.
Amazing, but it's got such a sharp edge.
Yes. Are you looking for like arrowheads, perhaps?
Yeah. I was looking at arrowheads. Originally, it caught my eye because I found what looks like. It looks like sea glass, but it's not really sea glass. It's like waterfall glass. And it's just cool because it's still got a little bit of writing on it, and there's kind of a bumpy texture to the bottle. Like, I don't know, it's not the kind of bottle that I just don't recognize it as being from anything.
Me neither.
See the ridge right here, and there's kind of a bump here and a bump to this side of it. And
now, why do they call it waterfall glass? It's not created by the waterfall, correct?
Well, no, but it's just bits of bottles and broken pieces that people have left behind. And over time, you find it in the ocean, it's just been washed by the water and the sand for so long that it smooths down all of the rough edges. I just called it waterfall glass because, I mean, there's certainly no ocean or sea around here, but
right.
And yet you can feel the edges of this thing have been smoothed down over time.
Right, who knows how long that's been there.
Yeah, exactly, and it's just a beautiful color, you know? They don't make glass like this anymore.
Right.
So, yeah, this could be very old.
Very old, and like Linda was saying, this is a cool place to look for arrowheads.
Yeah.
This is most likely not one, but
no.
It is the right area. There were several Native Americans up here.
Right.
There's the legend of the Native American maiden.
Right.
The Indian maiden who jumped from the waterfall to her death.
Yeah.
I believe that waterfall, though, that she jumped from is still up another waterfall higher. So this is not it, but there's several waterfalls that we climbed up already, and you can see quite a view from up here, from the top of that waterfall, and it's going to get even more magnificent as we go along. But keep your eyes open as you go along, because you never know with corrosion, erosion,
right,
whatever you want to call it, you never know what relics might surface. Now, what do you got there?
I just picked this up because you can see how big the rock is itself, but then when you turn it to the side, look how thin that is. I mean, it's like just little slivers of
right.
of rock.
Good tomahawk material.
Yes, exactly. You need to knock another stone against it and sharpen the edge.
Right.
Very cool, though.
Linda knocked the witchcraft rocks down.
I only knocked one off the top.
All right, so we're gonna mosey on up the trail to the next waterfall. It is quite a steep incline. And once again, what I would say is watch out for any falling rocks. There are people that walk around up above there. Also, when you're down under the waterfall, keep in mind there's people up there. So they might forget that there's people underneath and be chucking rocks off the side or even just hiking up above and they kick some down. So you really got to be careful about that. I think one thing that's interesting to note is like when we come up here where we're kind of closer to the treetops, mm-hmm. out of the ravine, it's brighter. It's a lot brighter. Like it feels
yeah.
like nighttime in the woods. But
right down
it definitely
there.
Gets darker earlier
yes.
in the woods. And you forget that it's only like 5 in the afternoon.
Right.
So it's really still early and we still got a good day ahead of us, but dark down there nonetheless.
Yes.
And cool. I like
yes,
it.
Nice
I like
cool.
it dark and cool. So let's go up around the bend here and see where this leads. So ladies and gentlemen, this flower right here, as we pointed out before, it's called mountain laurel. And mountain laurel is the state flower of Pennsylvania
and Connecticut.
Mm-hmm. And it's specific to the eastern United States.
Yes.
It's been found in southern Maine, all the way down to northern Florida, mm-hmm. and as far west as Louisiana and Indiana. So very beautiful, beautiful flower that grows all over the side of the mountain here at Lehigh Gorge State Park. And once again, a very steep ledge on the side of the trail here. Another place you have to watch your footing and watch below, because there's a trail down below. And as I said earlier, if people are hiking up here and whatnot, rocks could very easily get kicked down over that ledge. So look up as well as down where you're hiking along these trails. And beautiful scenery, and of course, perhaps a warning sign. So here we are, ladies and gentlemen, the view from the top of the falls. And I'm not gonna venture out where they
are because since I've been up here last, they put this rope here, and I don't want to go past that if people are dying and stuff like that. But you can see it's a long way down.
So tread with caution. And the top of these falls offer a beautiful view of the valley out there. Look at that. Amazing. Now we're going into a jungle of mountain laurel. It veers away from the stream a little bit. And some pretty cool terrain around here. We venture back to yet another waterfall. A little small waterfall. Pretty cool. And we're hiking up some more rocks here.
So go a little higher
through the mountain laurel and along the stream. And another beautiful little waterfall. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not recommending this. I'm not saying it's a good idea, but if you're gonna fill up your water bottle from a stream, I have been told to fill it up near a mossy ledge such as this one.
And that is because supposedly, and like I said, don't quote me on this, don't try it because you could get sick. There's like brain-eating amoebas and stuff like that. But I've been told that the moss kind of acts as a filter and will filter out the water a little bit. But they also sell a bunch of different filters you can get for water bottles and such to bring with you. I've seen them at various stores. I think it was Bass Pro Shop, maybe Dick's. One of those sporting goods stores had such an animal, which would be cool for a journey like this.
All right, so once again, on the trail that goes along these beautiful waterfalls, and a flowing little stream up the side of the mountain. And what's cool about this one is you can go behind it. You can trek over here and here we are, behind the waterfall. How cool is this? That's what it looks like behind the waterfall. This is something interesting. Perhaps Bigfoot's Dr. Pepper bottle. He didn't finish drinking it, maybe, and he put it back there in the rock to keep it cool by the waterfall. All right. And we come to an opening, once again giving us a view of the daylight and reminding us that it's still fairly early in the afternoon. This is the top of the waterfall that we're just under. And my concern with heights doesn't allow me to go too close to the edge there, but you get the idea. And I really like this part, how the stream just babbles along under the mountain laurel, along the rocks. And if you look back into the woods there, if you can see it, it just kind of peacefully flows between the rocks and boulders. It's very beautiful. And looking at it from this direction, you'd never imagine that there's that huge drop off right there.
That's right.
You know what I mean? Just a trickling little stream that opens up into that. So, you never know, but.
Yeah, it's amazing.
If we're not at the top, we should be very close.
Yes. Hopefully.
So let's go see where this opens up and we can get the view, or we can find the next waterfall, whichever comes first. Mm. Look at this. Perhaps the resting place of Bigfoot. I don't mean resting by like cemetery, I mean resting by stopping to rest. Maybe having a campfire up here at night. What do you think?
I think it's interesting that somebody would take the time and, you know, pile all those rocks up just like before and then throw sticks on top of it. Definitely looks like the makings of a campfire though.
Perhaps a Bigfoot hoax.
Could be.
Yeah.
Could be.
Interesting. Look at this. Look at this, it's like steps that go up here. This definitely looks like some Bigfoot country up here. Or at least bear country, so. Either way, some very big boulders and such.
Are you sure we're going the right way?
Let's see. Yeah, this is the right way.
How do you know from tasting that?
From tasting this? I know from the orange dot on the tree. Come on. And here we come to a beautiful view of the town from high up here atop the mountain. As I said, this looks like a little train platform from up here.
You can see the little buildings and the church towering above most of the other buildings.
Mountains in the background, what a beautiful sight. Alright, coming down the mountain here, we found what looks like a foundation. And there's another part over there. And I don't know if you can see it, but there's several
rock pile structures throughout the woods. And an interesting line of rocks up here, too.
Seems to go along the trail.
Stone weren't placed where they were placed here. Like the entrance to something, like you were supposed to walk up maybe steps.
Right, and then there's some more steps in the background there.
Yeah.
And also, I notice up here, there's the pole for the old telegraph wires.
So perhaps something to do with the train
was around this area here.
Or the hotel.
Or the hotel.
I don't know. That looks like steps.
Does, doesn't it?
Too well formed to be natural.
And the train tracks are way down there. So I'm not sure if the telegraph wires associated with those tracks are
the same ones that stand up here on the hill, kind of overgrown.
What's interesting about this old telegraph pole here, is that it looks very charred.
It looks burned.
Which kind of makes me wonder. I know the old hotel
was destroyed by a forest fire.
So could that be remnants of that same forest fire? And it looks like there's some coal down here on the ground.
And there's little deposits or piles of coal all throughout this little path here.
Now this one says 1812.
And is it just me, or does it look like there used to be a doorway under there?
It damn sure did. There's definitely a doorway there that they've, I don't know, filled in with concrete.
So this one would be 1812, much
older than the one that's still in use across.
Right.
Or next to it, the one that we just heard the
right.
Train going over. That one over there is, was it 1913, I believe?
Yeah. 1812 is old.
Yes, it is.
Really old.
Yes.
Wonder why they would have left it here, though.
To drive across, I guess.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Thank you for tuning in as we took you on a tour through Lehigh Gorge State Park and for joining us on our expedition up along Glen Onoko Falls, which is steeped in history, legends, and lore. Pretty cool place, scenic park. Tread with caution if you hike those trails. There are some very dangerous parts, and in case
yes.
You miss all the signs and happen to see this video, we just want you to know it's dangerous. It can be.
Yeah, and wear something better than $30 hiking boots too.
Yes, absolutely. Unless you want to wear some diehard hiking boots, which are $30.
Those are actually work
and
boots.
Quite. There you have it.
Maybe that's the best thing.
Could be.